Good morning, Wallace Presbyterian Church. Happy post Labor Day. Hope you all have had a wonderful long weekend and are rest and restored and ready to go for the week. I wanted, as promised, to talk about the Daily Time with God readers and how I use this plan. And before I do that, I want to address two barriers that I have both personally experienced when I try to do some type of devotional reading plan, but also that I've experienced just doing ministry for 15 years and hearing how people, you know, hearing their concerns and issues with doing reading plans and things like that. And so the first one is time. A lot of people will say, Christians will say, you know, I'll start something, but then as I go on throughout the week or the months, I just don't feel like I have the time in my daily life to do something like that. And so I may get through a couple of weeks of it, but then, you know, we fill our schedules with so much and I just don't have the time for it. And so maybe that's you, I don't know. The second thing that we find that I hear a lot about is just motivation in general. We're good at starting things typically, but making them a part of our daily routine is a challenge. And so I think about how we are a culture of New Year's resolutions. We are great at wanting to make some type of resolution at the beginning of a year, and usually by February, if February, you know, we've either forgotten it or we clearly are not following whatever that resolution was. All to say, we're good at starting things. We're not good at putting those things into the daily routines of our life and really actually making something realistic that we can do over the long haul. So with those two barriers, this plan addresses both of those, and here's how. The first one is this plan, at least for starting it out, is no more than 20 minutes. And what I mean by that is I want you to set a timer for 20 minutes, and I want you to get through as much as you can or as little as you can or whatever you can do for 20 minutes. And after 20 minutes, I want you to close this up and go on with your day. So that's the first thing. Now, obviously, you can do more than 20 minutes, but this is set for a 20-minute read a day, maybe two or three times a week. Maybe it's a weekly thing for you, whatever you can do. So again, 20 minutes, that's it. And if somebody wants to tell me they don't have 20 minutes in their day, week, whatever to do with this, then we probably have some bigger issues that we need to discuss. Second thing is, as far as starting something and continuing it, a lot of the frustration that I've experienced with starting a Bible reading plan or some type of a devotional is that I will miss a day and then I'll have to add that day to the next day in order to keep up. So maybe you're doing a reading through the Bible and a year plan and you know, you didn't do Monday's reading. And so if you're going to try to get through the Bible in a year, you've got to do Mondays now with Tuesdays. And so now you're adding time to that. Maybe you go on vacation and you just, you know, forget to do your reading. And so now you've got like a whole week or 5 days to add on to this. And it just becomes, now I've got this hour and a half long devotional to do if I'm going to actually get through the Bible in a year. And those are the things that stop us from doing this. And so this plan doesn't do that. There is no, well, if we missed yesterday, we have to add that to today. That does not exist here. If you didn't do a reading on Monday, you don't add it to Tuesday. You just pick up wherever the text has you, and that's where you go. That's what you do. Because the goal is time with God. It's getting the word in, and it's allowing it to do what the word does, shape us, inform us, and teach us about God and ourselves. And so that's the purpose. It's not about checking a box. It's not about accomplishing some lifelong goal you've had of reading the Bible. There's no extra points for getting through everything. There's no extra points for reading the Bible in a year. Sorry. The purpose is actually getting the word in us and letting it do its work. And whether that's 20 minutes a day, whether that's 20 minutes a week, whatever your routine is going to be, the word is powerful and able to do those things. And that's why we do it. We don't do it to brag about how much we're reading and whatever we would do. So, okay, so to that end, hopefully I've been at my point there. Here's how I use this. So I set my timer for 20 minutes and open my Bible to the text. So we'll start with September 19th. That'll be the next text here, which will be John 3, 1 to 21. I'll pray. I'll ask God to just be with me, to open my eyes to His Word. And I'll set my timer for 20 minutes. I'll hit it and I'll read John chapter 3, verses 1 to 21. And just read it. That's it. After I read it, I'll go to the study the word section that says list any truth that's striking, an example to follow, a command to obey, or what's confusing about the text. Now, what needs to be noted is that sometimes there isn't in, you know, all these things don't necessarily always exist in the passage that I read for the day. Sometimes there isn't a command to obey. Sometimes there isn't an example to follow. Most of the time there's something confusing and I'll write it down in my journal to ask the pastor later. But just those questions are more diagnostic questions for the text so that you're just not, you know, you're engaging it to some degree. And so don't be alarmed if, well, I'm not really finding anything here to obey. Sometimes that's not the case. So move on. But those four questions, after that, it says choose your favorite verse from today's reading, put the basic teaching or verse into your own words. This is something I try to do every time, for sure, because this is what allows me to, when I take a verse and I rethink it and I put it in my own words, it helps it stick and it helps me know that text more. And this is what will also be something that I kind of carry with me. I carry with me throughout the day. So that's the study of the word. Then we move on to the meditation. And it says, write down what the text shows you. One, about God and about God that you should praise and thank Him for. Two, about my sin that I should confess and repent of. Three, about a need that I should ask for. Four, how would this change your life if you took it seriously? Why might God be showing you this now? And again, just like the questions before, sometimes there isn't anything in the text that is, showing me a sin that I should confess or repent of. Sometimes there isn't something here that I'm reading that, reveals a need that I should ask for. What's good about these questions, though, is that these actually go with you as well. And so if my timer ends here, I've read my text for the day, and I have these questions, and I'm going to carry that with me, whether I'm going to work, going to the store, whether I'm in traffic. And this is how we feed on the word. And I might actually, as I'm thinking about that text later on in the afternoon, I might actually come to a conclusion about something that this text reveals that I should praise God about or thank Him for, or maybe a sin that I should confess. And so that's how this works. Lastly, prayer. You'll pray to the meditations if you have time, which are adoration, confession, thanksgiving, and petition. Adoration would be things that I adore God for, praises to Him. Confession would be anything that my scripture reading or just time with the Lord has revealed about myself that I need to confess. So confessing sin. Thanksgiving, things I need to give thanks for God, and could be His attributes again, could be His general grace and mercy to me that has been made known or made afresh to me from my reading, or it could just be thanksgiving for the weather, for His provision in general for me or for my family. Lastly, petition, what you might need to ask the Lord for. And then after that, we see pray your needs and pressing concerns. And so this is, again, don't be afraid to ask the Lord for what's on your heart, what you're afraid of, or what you need to ask Him for. There isn't anything too big or too small that we can't bring to Him and that He doesn't ask us to bring to Him. So do that. And then lastly, and this is probably one of my most favorite parts of this study that I always add to the study, whether I'm out of time or not, says take a final moment just to enjoy God and His presence. And so I don't know if this is, for me growing up in sort of reform circles, this was a new one for me. And so I didn't spend a whole lot of time in silence, enjoying the presence of God. That seemed kind of strange at first. But as I've been doing this and then coupling it with just the pace of our lives today, our culture, technology, media, we're always on the go, information overload. There are so many things that are distracting us. To find 2 or 3 minutes to just be in silence is kind of a rarity. And so this offers that. And so even if I don't get through everything and my timer goes off, maybe while I'm kind of going through that third meditation, I will jump down here. I'm realizing this says mediation. That's a typo. It should be meditation. Anyways, we'll get that fixed. But I'll jump down here and I have two or three more minutes just to be in silence and to enjoy God's presence and to practice that, to learn how to do that. So that's how I use this. Again, 20 minutes, start there. If you want to do longer, great, but don't beat yourself up. Nobody gets bonus points for doing an hour. Just do something. And then lastly, if you can also use this study if it's not for a sermon series. One of the things I do is if you are familiar with the McShane reading program, I think it's the McShane Read the Bible in a Year. You can Google that. He'll give you four verses to read per day, and this is in order to get through the Bible in a year. Okay, we're not doing that. What we are doing is we're using the verses, and I'll take one of those Old Testament verses and one of those New Testament readings, and I'll do this time with God with those two verses. And again, that's if I'm not doing a series, if I'm not in a study like this, and I just want to get into the Word that day, I'll grab whatever day he has there, and I will pick again one of those Old Testament, one of those New Testaments. Why? Because it usually is too long to do four scripture readings, and two, I'm too lazy to pick the text, so I'll have McShane pick them for me. That's just me being honest. It's all there for you. I've got the plan here. I've got my journal to put any notes or questions, but more importantly, I have spent some time in the Word that day or that week, and I'm excited to see what that does for Wallace as we together get in God's Word, whether it's in a sermon series like the one we're about to start, or just your daily reading plan that you are doing as you spend time with the Lord. So as always, email me with the questions that you have. I look forward to having this work its way into the fabric of Wallace Presbyterian Church and what the Lord will do through it. Thank you so much, and I hope you all are having a great day. Bye.